President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. confident the recently concluded trilateral summit between Manila, Washington, and Tokyo will improve the situation in the region. Beijing's maritime aggression was front and center during the historic event, with the three nations expressing solid commitment to ensure freedom of navigation in the West Philippine Sea.
We explored ways of enhancing our cooperation in a number of areas of mutual concern, including in enhancing economic resilience and security, promoting inclusive growth and development, addressing climate change, and maritime cooperation. I emphasize that trilateral cooperation between the U.S., Japan, and the Philippines is a natural progression of the strong relations between close allies.
Aside from defense, the Philippines also bagged investment pledges from the summit. America and Japan committed billions of pesos worth of investments covering the sectors of communication, semiconductor, and nuclear energy. The U.S. International Development Finance Corporation also pouring in $20 million for housing projects in the country.
I'm confident that our collaborative efforts will pave the way for a brighter, more prosperous future for the Indo-Pacific region. Together, we can harness the power of infrastructure and innovation to drive sustainable development and economic growth.
Now, transport groups Piston and Manibela staging another two-day transport strike in protest of the government's PUV modernization program. The groups are demanding that transport officials reconsider their decision to stick to the April 30 consolidation deadline. At least 20,000 drivers and operators are expected to join the strike. But authorities assure commuters the government is ready.
Nagpasubmit na kami ng inventory ng assets ng lahat ng government agencies at mga NGOs. So far, I think we have sufficient number ng pang-augment na mga buses, vans. Kung may mga namomonitor na ng haharas or namumwersa ng mga drivers para sumama sa tigil pasada, kagad naman yan ibabato on the ground. Naka-preposition din naman yung ating mga kapulisan.
The Office of Transportation Cooperatives claims 78% of operators in the country have already consolidated, but Manibela doubts the accuracy of that number.
Regarding sa percentage kasi, as per the report of LTFRB sa ating Pangulo noong December pa, for us to reach 60 to 65% is already a good number. For us to reach 78%, definitely it's a very good number for us to go ahead with this program.
Sabi nila dati, 3% na lang ang hindi nakakapag-consolidate. Alam nyo, pabago-bago. Pagka wala ka talagang tamang datos, nagsisinungaling ka.
Take a look at the flash business headlines from overseas. The much-contested acquisition of U.S. Steel, now a step closer to becoming a reality. The shareholders just approved the nearly $15 billion proposed acquisition by Japan's Nippon Steel despite political opposition. On to more news, German Chancellor Olaf Scholz brings a warning as he visits China this week. Failure to act on Europe's warnings to end discriminatory business practices will result in escalation of tensions. That is the warning. And a once every 4 years Bitcoin software update called the Halving, set to trigger multi-billion dollar declines in revenue for the companies that ensure Bitcoin's smooth functioning. Around April 20, the Halving will cut the amount of Bitcoin that miners can earn each day for validating transactions to 450 from 900 today. Bitcoin holders watching out for that moment to see if prices will spike. On to more news, BNP Paribas signs an agreement with China's Fosun Group to acquire around 9% of its stake in Belgian insurer Aegis. While Boston is anticipating a $200 million economic windfall as it prepares, this is the next story, as it prepares for the 128th Boston Marathon. The event takes place Monday, set to welcome 30,000 runners. And a vast number of spectators from over 130 countries. Finally, Nike unveils a barrage of new products as it hopes the shoes can reignite its fortunes. The shoes, which was released ahead of the Paris Olympics set for July, include an Alpha Fly built for marathoners, improved track spikes, boots for footballers, and its landmark Pegasus shoes.